Only half of Filipinos confident about government's evaluation of COVID-19 vaccines. In a survey conducted by the social weather stations, 51% of the respondents say they're confident with how Philippine regulators assess the vaccines. 31% are uncertain, while 17% are not confident. The poll was conducted from April 28 to May 2. The result came just a day after local government units were ordered not to announce vaccine brands that they will administer. The Interior Department set to release guidelines on Malacañang's directive not to declare the COVID-19 vaccine brand that will be used by local governments. The DILG says those getting their jabs will only know the brand of the vaccine on the day of inoculation. Should they decline, they will have to go to the back of the line of their priority group. Interior Undersecretary Jonathan Malaya urging the public to take the shots that are already available.
So yung pakiusap namin sa ating mga kababayan, huwag na po tayong maging choosy. Because a large portion of the population are already getting vaccinated, regardless of brand. And we are appealing to all that everybody knows, no? I hope everybody knows that all vaccines approved by the Food and Drug Administration are efficacious and safe. Therefore, all of them will help us achieve herd immunity, and all of them will allow us to end this pandemic.
Metro mayors are set to discuss the new directive from President Duterte. Local officials are at odds on its implementation. But Metro Manila Mayor's Chairman Edwin Olivares sees nothing wrong with it.
At ngayon po, pina-implement po namin po ngayon, hindi po ina-announce na po yung vaccine doon sa particular vaccination center. At sasabihin ko po sa inyo, wala rin naman tayong available na stock na po ng Pfizer at saka Gamaleya. Ang stock lang po natin is Sinovac at AstraZeneca.
The Philippines' supply of Pfizer vaccines from the WHO's COVAX facility set to go to indigent Filipinos, Kanyang spokesperson. This is in compliance with the COVAX's policy to give the vaccines to the most vulnerable. The Philippines expects to receive a second shipment from the COVAX facility containing 2.2 million more doses of Pfizer jabs. New tests conducted by BioNTech show the Pfizer vaccine is still highly effective against the variant first detected in India. Preliminary studies show the variant spreads more easily, with some evidence showing it may evade protection by protection provided by existing vaccines. BioNTech says when the blood of people vaccinated with its jab was exposed to the variant, 25 to 30% fewer antibodies were detected. The Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine is around 95% effective against the original version of the virus. Waiving the intellectual property rights for the COVID-19 vaccines won't be enough to narrow the huge vaccine supply gaps between the rich and poor countries. That's according to the World Trade Organization. It says a technology transfer and many other capabilities are needed, since these vaccines are harder to produce than ordinary drugs.
To have solved the problem, the unacceptable problem of inequity in access to vaccines, we have to be holistic. It's not one or the other. If we don't pursue a comprehensive strategy that I outlined before, I do not believe that we will increase the volume of vaccines. So I've already said quite a bit on that, and I think we should focus. And I want us to go fast, because this is about lives. I don't want us to take years again to negotiate this issue.
South Africa and India have been urging fellow WTO members to waive the IP rights on the vaccines to boost global production. Poor countries that make up half of the world's population have received just 17% of the doses.